2014 has been a wonderful year for the crew of TSP, with many great locations that we have discovered. But we are always honored to return to Augusta, Kentucky, to host the annual Halloween Ghost Walk. Augusta is like home to us, like stepping back into time. We are joined this year with a group of 50 people to experience the history and hauntings of Augusta, Kentucky, in four locations. The old Augusta Jail, the Riverfront House, Parkview Inn, and an old church that has a very twisted past. And this year, we are joined by the amazing Cassidy Ray. Mission to find the truth of the supernatural experiences that my family witnessed when I was a child in Southern California. I am now joined by my good friends, Patrick Shields, Rick White, Chad Summerfield, and Derek Mack. Together, we explore the claims of supernatural activities. No matter what we encounter, we will continue our search for the existence unknown.
Don't cry, my love, don't cry no more.
Augusta is located in Bracken County, Kentucky, at the convergence of the Ohio River and Bracken Creek, approximately 42 miles east of Cincinnati, Ohio. The Ohio River borders the northern part of the city. It flows in a straight westerly direction for 9 miles without the obstruction of a flood wall. Riverside Drive in Augusta offers an incredible long-range view of this picturesque river valley. But on September 27th, 1862, things were not so pretty. Colonel Basil Duke led 7 companies, 350 men of Morgan's Raiders, with 2 pieces of artillery onto the Cemetery Hill overlooking the town. Augusta was being protected by 150 home guards under the direction of Colonel Joshua T. Bradford and 3 Union gunboats stationed just offshore. After Duke fired only a few rounds of artillery, the gunboats abandoned their posts, leaving the town without proper protection. A fierce battle ensued on the streets in the center of town. 35 men lost their lives that day, and many more were wounded. Colonel Duke ordered several of the buildings to be set afire. A monument was erected in the 1880s commemorating the death of 11 unknown Confederate soldiers who lost their life in that battle.
Constricts and chokes like ruthless vines.
All right, check it out, guys. This is the first time ever we're doing this, man. This is going to be awesome. We're doing a live investigation for Halloween. All these people. We've never done this before, so this is going to be crazy. I think some of us are going to poop, some of us are going to pee, some of us are going to scream, might even run up a tree, and I'm a poet and didn't know it. So here we go, guys, we're going to have a fun night. This is a cool thing for the search of existence unknown, and you know what, guys, I wish he was here. So,
yeah,
did you hear that? This guy just, come here, dude, come here. This guy right here, what'd you say?
Hell yeah.
See?
We going to do this.
That's right, this guy right here, we're going to knock it out.
Yeah, let's go.
Oh, see ya. If you haven't signed up for the release form to be on our, this is an episode we're filming tonight, please sign up over there. If you haven't paid yet, hit up Jackie right here. And so we're going to get started. So first off, I want to tell everybody thank you for coming. This town's a big passion for us. We've been coming to Augusta for about 8 years now. A little bit about my crew. We're Tri-State Paranormal in Northern Kentucky. We started in 2008, but I've been researching the paranormal for 30 years now. My brothers, Derek's been 15, Pat's been about 10, and Chad is our newest crew member and a new member on the show. So we like to break him in right, and so this is one of the first things he's ever done. So if he acts shy, tell him to talk. Make him, you know, actually, you know, I think Chad, you need to stand.
Just put him in front. Just put him in the very front.
Try to move him. Never mind, fuck it. Orlando, sorry. Anyway, but really, guys, what we do, we started the show about 3 years ago. Somebody came up to us and said, hey, we love your approach, because we like to dismiss almost everything and leave the unknown and go into the unknown. I tell you what, some of the things that we do, some of the places we came across and with our techniques, it's pretty mind-blowing. And we get some amazing results, especially in this town, in this building, the jail, the riverfront house, and the new place we're going to investigate tonight is a bed and breakfast right here at Parkview Inn. We've been trying to get in there for a while. So, my brother Patrick right here, he's going to be sticking his camera in your face here, and everybody say hi and whatnot. And there you go.
There's one.
Hi.
Hi.
There you go. Hello. Hi. So, hi everybody again, and what's your name? Okay, good. So, we got everybody's name, right? Yeah, good. All right, it's on the list. I'm good to go. You good to go?
Yeah.
All right, now,
let's go off the list.
You to Cassidy Ray. Cassidy Ray right now, I'm going to tell you right now, this is nothing against her, she's just a sweetheart. But we really don't believe in psychics and mediums, and we're kind of doubtful because there's so many out there that are false. Cassidy, we met her a while back, and I tell you what, she is mind-blowing. She has made us from a skeptic to a believer. And that's very hard for us to become a believer. Cassidy, you have the floor, big girl.
Okay. So, like you said, I'm Cassidy. I'm 16 and I'm a medium. So that means I can see, hear, feel, and communicate with spirits.
And it's okay. It's okay. That's a loud spirit. Calm down. We'll get to you later.
That was not paranormal.
Traveling around for about 3 years now. We go to places to investigate. We've been to Vegas. We're from Kentucky, so we're pretty close to these guys. And this is like my first time investigating with you guys, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Yeah, first time investigating with them. So I'm really excited, and I'm really glad they invited me to come on this and meet all you guys and hang out with you. And I don't really know what else to say, but I'm excited.
Yeah. You guys have any questions?
Nobody ever has questions.
God, that's so awesome, man.
Yeah.
That is so awesome.
I have a question.
Yes, ma'am.
Will our loved ones be any on this adventure with us, possibly?
Well, I've pretty much controlled my gift to a point where in readings and things, I can block out spirits from readings and spirits from investigations. So, if we have time in any part of this, I can do a couple readings, but everything's really tiring with this, and I want to be able to investigate with everybody all these locations.
So,
okay, thank you.
So, here we go, and let's head on out.
Okay.
All right, so what we can do, I can take you through here and show you some of the spots up here. There are some parts in this building that will feel heavy. We noticed it last time, that it just felt like it was almost draining your energy out of you. And I don't know if anybody's ever experienced that feeling before. It's almost like it makes you extremely tired. Like you just don't want to do anything. Almost just like, you know, I'm done. That's what happens when the energy drains out of you. So let's go upstairs. I mean, everybody, please be careful. If you want to walk around right now, just kind of get a feel and a vibe of the house. That's one thing we do when we go on locations. We feel what the place offers. Just gonna get a sense of it, you know. Sometimes you might pick up on something that feels odd to you. So if you guys wanna walk around, take turns coming upstairs so we don't kill each other going up and down these stairs, you're more than welcome. So whoever wants to come on up.
Individual.
After a brief walkthrough of the Parkview Inn, we would head up to the infamous old Augusta Jail, where we as TSP have had some very amazing personal experiences. Right now we're standing in the Augusta Jail, which was built in 1811. Now this place has seen its fair share of sadness. One time we came here to investigate this place, we captured a little boy who died of cholera. The sad story about that is that he was a slave. He was taken away from his parents and he was to be sold here. But unfortunately he died alone without his mom and dad of cholera. Very sad thing. Right behind me is what they called the little dungeon, where they actually kept some of the worst people in, but mainly for the slaves, they kept them in here. It's kind of crazy to see this inside the jail. Right above us is where the sheriff lived, him and his family. So this place is very small, but it's one of the first operating jails here in Kentucky. Still stands today, very historic. A lot of activity happened here.
Right before we begin to make our way to the Parkview Inn, our dear friend Jay Lynch has a few words to share.
It's all Patrick Shields. It's his fault. He did it. It's Patrick Shields.
Okay. Well, guys, come on in. Welcome to the Parkview Country Inn. And originally, this was a stagecoach and a bar type area, when you wet your whistle. We had a Liberty Stable next door. The front that you actually are standing at was a front porch full of rocking chairs. And at some point it changed. It was called Gallenstein's Tavern. And it's had quite a few claims of things happening here. We've had people to stay here to say that. We have people, the innkeepers, that have told us stories of things that happened. It's probably most two noticed thing that I want to think about when I think about anything happening here is a little boy called Christopher. And he got sick, and it was during the cholera epidemic, and they had just made it here, and they were going to pick up his parents.
Sorry.
And he was so sick that they stopped here, him and his grandmother, and stayed here. They got him a room, and they were going to go out west. The grandfather was going to go out west to pick him up. I do believe the grandmother went with him too. I'm not real sure about that, but for any reason, they both went out west. They left little Christopher here alone, and when they got back with his parents, Christopher had passed away. Of course, when you have any kind of plague epidemic, they bury you very quickly, and he's buried at the Payne Cemetery and on an unmarked grave. But there's been claims of little Christopher sitting on the steps to your left. You'll see the stairs there. People see a little boy sitting there waiting for his parents to come back to pick him up because he died before they got back to get him.
Now that we have finished giving a tour of all the haunted locations, we head back to the church to divide up our teams and begin the investigations.
So is everybody gonna follow in here, or you? So I was drawn in here because I kept seeing, like, at first it just looked like a mist, or like when a car goes by and the lights go through the window. It just looked like that, and it just kept going back and forth right here where I'm sitting, towards the wall, just back and forth. But like, I started looking at it more and paying more attention to it. It looked like a little girl. And when I was talking to you guys out there, she kept like coming up to the doorway, and she'd reach her hand out and touch my arm, and then she'd run back in here. Kind of like she was just messing with me and getting my attention, then running back out. But right now she's standing over on this wall next to Chad. Her head comes up to about his elbow. So, and she looks like she's about 7 or 8. And she's got her hair pulled back. It's in 2 really low pigtails over her shoulders. And she's just wearing a little white dress. And I'm not good at asking questions, so.
Anybody feel free. Ask any questions.
What is your name?
Mary. Yeah, so her name's Mary.
Why is she still here?
She said that she doesn't have anywhere else to go. She said this place makes her happy, because it's where she grew up. That's a car if anybody has a recorder running.
What's really interesting about this moment and the upcoming events that take place, it truly sounds like a little girl is saying yes to Cassidy's statement.
She said that she doesn't have anywhere else to go. She said this place makes her happy because it's where she grew up. That's a car if anybody has a recorder running. And if you look, she said that she doesn't have anywhere else to go. She said this place makes her happy because it's where she grew up. That's a car if anybody has a recorder running. And if you look, she said that she doesn't have anywhere else to go. She said this place makes her happy because it's where she grew up. That's a car if anybody has a recorder running.
I hear something. The cement.
Yeah, that's outside.
Were you lonely?
It just got really, really, really hot. And I'm standing by this window with the draft.
Okay, I'm going back there. You stay right here.
Okay. I also heard like a thud or whatever noise.
I heard
back
that
there.
Too.
Did you?
Yeah, I heard that thud.
Right here. It's extremely hot. And there's this window right here.
That's the people outside doing something.
Who's all in here with you?
We got three other people. Chase, Sadie, and Jace.
Where's Jace?
Jace right
here. Oh, there you are.
But it's like cold in this corner. I don't get it.
It's hot right here.
Mm-hmm. Nearby that window.
Yeah, the window's right here.
Someone just moan?
No, I told Kane to stop moving.
That was someone clearing her throat.
That was me.
Okay. Is the car pulling up outside? Okay, we're in the jails right now, and what's your name?
Jackson.
You guys gotta understand, it's like 40 degrees outside right now, and the...
Do you want to step in here? Feel
the
it?
Windows are just bars, there's no glass. And Jackson is standing in this jail cell by a window, and it's getting hot where he's standing. Do what?
I just felt something on my hand.
What was you doing?
I was just holding the bar.
Did you just say something?
No, I've been silent whole time.
Right after our guest asked, "Were you lonely?" it seems she got a direct response by something knocking, not to mention the other strange experiences that everyone was having. From warm air being felt by a cold window and the feeling of somebody having their hand touched. Could this be the energy inside the jail from the young male spirit that we experienced there before?
lonely.
It just got really, really, really hot, and I'm standing by this window.
Were you lonely?
It just got really, really, really hot, and I'm standing by this window.
Were you lonely?
It just got really, really, really hot, and I'm standing by this window.
Are you welcome in your house?
What has all of us truly stumped is that everyone was accounted for during this session. Derek's group was with him on the main floor conducting audio and spirit box sessions. And what's even more strange about this, you can even see Jay Lynch looking up to the top of the stairs as if something or someone has caught his attention. Then Kevin, with the camera, turned up there to see if somebody was there because he heard something moving. You can clearly see somebody sitting at the top of the landing on a small bench just under the window. And not too soon after that, Derek heads up to the bench. And as you see, there's nobody sitting there. This is truly unexplainable, or could this be one of the spirits that still remain in the riverfront house?
She really likes you, Chad.
Those kids do.
Cassie. Let me show you all something real quick.
Hi, Cassie.
This was, as I just walked in the room, laying in these two ladies here with one around the edge of the bed. Pushing on the edge of the bed, and if you watch the shows, they don't show enough of what they actually get on there. You'll hear them talking, but you hear somebody completely over top of them. I don't catch what it says, like four words, while they're pushing on the bed. But this is what was right there when I was just walking in.
Says, oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh.
This was one of the most clearest EVPs that Jason has ever captured to date. He captured this Class A EVP in a room across the hall from Cassidy. In this room was Elena, Lisa, and Peggy, and you can clearly hear another voice, possibly the small girl that Cassidy has been talking about, talking over the ladies.
You'll hear them talking, but you hear somebody completely over top of them. I don't catch what it says, like four words, while they're pushing on the bed. But this is what was right there when I was just walking in.
Are they the, remember the one bed that...
A little bit. Yeah, they're still talking.
Is that you, Alex?
What's that with me every time?
Was it, you didn't hear that? You moved your chair or something?
My bad.
Was it you?
I don't think it was me, but I'm kind of fat.
Or can you come out to this circle right here? What does that sound like?
Like footsteps.
I hear footsteps, yeah. If that's you, can you do something a little bit more closer to us? Maybe open that door? The front door? All you gotta do is push it.
Someone humming.
I hear them. Is anybody humming? Saying anything? Whispering?
No.
No. There's somebody humming.
All right.
You can barely hear the sounds of someone humming, which when my group was in this church before Pat's team, we heard something very similar to what Pat captured. Again, this is very faint, but it has the same sounds of what we heard earlier.
Someone humming.
I hear them.
Someone humming.
I hear them.
Someone humming.
I hear them.
Not that, before that.
I heard it out in the hallway.
In the hallway. Okay. Who wants to go with me in the hallway?
Not me.
Oh, sorry.
There's a shadow right here.
There's a shadow back here.
Where? Hold up.
Neither of ours.
Hold up.
No, don't move. Don't move.
Don't move.
Everybody stay in your spot. Please stay in your spot.
Oh my gosh.
Who said this? Damn ball. Who lays their balls around? Oops, sorry. All right, that's right. You got the sense of the sorry, dude. All right. Oh, it's in your face, dude. Sorry. Where's the shadow, man?
It was in the corner.
That's where it was cold at.
It got cold. It's like really dark. I can sort of see it. I don't like it.
That's for my camera. Alright. I'm gonna check out this hallway.
Oh, I'll go.
Whoa. Whoa, whoa.
Fill it.
Yeah.
Where's your whole thing at? Where you can talk?
It's in my hand. Damn, that's getting louder. Audio session end. Audio session 2, jail. Hello?
You felt right.
All right, hold on real quick.
Gosh.
Hold on real quick, everybody.
Shh.
Just, hold on.
Shh.
Wow, that's crazy.
Okay, I'm here.
All right. If you're in this building right now, knock on something, please.
Okay, somebody's rolling something upstairs.
All right, you know what? All right, I gotta go outside and check, see if someone snuck in upstairs. And yet again, we hear walking and banging above us in the old sheriff's house. And after I ask if you are still in the jail with us, you hear a direct response. Hold on real quick, everybody.
Shh.
Hold on. Shh. Crazy.
Okay, I'm here.
All right. If you're in this building right now, knock on something, please. Hold Hold on real quick, everybody. Hold on. Wow, that's crazy.
Okay, I'm hearing something upstairs.
All right. If you're in this building right now, knock on something, please. Hold on real quick, everybody. Hold on. Wow, that's crazy.
Okay, I'm hearing something upstairs.
Alright. If you're in this building right now, knock on something, please.
He said his name was George Edward, if anybody asked that.
I was just fixing to ask what his name was.
What is the woman's name?
She said it was Lucille, but she's not a big fan of that name.
Is she the one that said they're all over?
She just kind of shook her head and looked down. She said, too many. She keeps, like, turning so her back's towards all of us more.
Why are they here?
He told me traveling and passing through. So that makes me think maybe if he's an intelligent spirit, then he might not have passed here, but revisiting places that he was, or he's residual.
I have asked him if he likes it here or something.
Okay. Now, I wasn't recording. How I do this is I'll hear something on the recorder. I'll let it run 3 seconds beyond that, so I know exactly where I caught it at. Why are they here, or how long is it you? Mm-hmm. But for now, I've got it here before she ever said anything, because I can hear a little bit when I'm going back over. What was it she said whenever you asked? What was the question you asked?
I asked, why are they here?
What did you say?
He said, traveling, passing through.
Okay. Now, this is what happened. I'll play this back so everybody can hear it. It's kind of faint, but you should be able to hear passing real well. When you ask the question, I'll play it back so everybody can hear her. Right after that, you'll hear a whisper that says, passing. Let me go back to where you started.
She keeps, like, turning so her back's towards all of us more.
Why are they here?
This time, in that very same room where Jason captured that Class A EVP, he captured what sounds like part of a conversation Cassidy may have been having with the male spirit that was there with them.
She's like turning so her back's towards all of us more.
Why are they here?
She keeps like turning so her back's towards all of us more.
Why are they here?
She keeps like turning so her back's towards all of us more.
Why are they here?
What was that? Was someone whispering or anything? Did someone hear that? Did you hear that?
It sounded like it came from this room right here.
What did it sound like?
Like a click, kind of like something.
clicking or like that.
Should be something in there, like we'll stop on this. That was actually.
I think Elaine is in there.
No, she's actually in the room over here.
What is really wild about this moment and the following events that are about to happen, the man sitting in the chair at the end of the hall and 35 minutes later, two other guests are truly frightened by sounds that are happening and feelings that they felt in these rooms upstairs in the riverfront house.
Did he shoot you? Maybe you don't want to talk. Tell you what, we're going to ask you questions. Yes or no questions. And if the answer is yes, I want you to knock once. If the answer is no, I want you to knock twice. Please, if you don't mind. Did someone murder you? What?
I don't know.
Why?
Because as soon as you said that,
yeah, the clicking sound again in that room.
Really?
Yeah. It was like three times again that.
That dude, crazy. I swear something just touched my foot.
Yeah, like
try. I feel like when I breathe, like something's pushing on me.
Yeah, like try to raise up. Like try to. Does it feel like pressure?
Yeah, there's a lot of resistance.
Yeah, that's how I felt when I was getting up.
Does that mean she wants us to stay in the bed or get out? Or?
It's probably affecting it. Just to the point where maybe make you feel uncomfortable so you get out. You good?
I don't know if this means anything, but my like left ear is like burning and my right one's freezing.
My right one's like really hot. And my left side feels really hot. Do you want us to get out of your bed? Oh no. I swear to God, I just heard someone say yes.
Really? In your ear?
All the groups would change up locations one more time as my group heads to the Parkview Inn for our final investigation of the night.
Okay, this is number two, bed and breakfast, Parkview. Okay, this room is kind of nice.
It's beautiful.
Who's all up here right now with us?
Well, before you get started there's already something saying.
Already?
Yeah.
God. That's quick.
I wouldn't go in a room. I was trying to find these others. Right after you said this room's kind of nice, it says, where's it going?
Damn, already.
And yet again, in the very same room that Jason captured two amazing EVPs earlier, this time he captured what sounded like a woman asking, "What's that?" in response to one of the guests stating that the room is beautiful.
beautiful. Beautiful. Beautiful.
It has always been a true pleasure for the TSB crew to host a Halloween ghost hunts in Augusta, Kentucky. It seems that the old Augusta jail has never let us down any time when we come to investigate, and finally able to investigate the very much desired Parkview Inn and capturing the voices of her past. The riverfront house possibly showing that her history is still reaching out to anybody willing to listen or even see. Augusta, Kentucky is a town of very rich history, from the Clooney family to Heather Renee French of Miss America. You can even visit the Rosemary Clooney Museum, which is inside her old home when she lived there in Augusta, Kentucky. And to the lost souls that still seem to hold on are remembered on two plaques in a small part of town. And to a dear friend of ours experiencing the energy of a spirit trying to communicate with her inside of the Parkview Inn. Just goes to show that this beautiful, small, quiet town of Augusta, Kentucky, nestled away on the side of Ohio River, has so much to offer with her history and the spirits. Happy Halloween, everybody.